As China's economy grows, so does the child labor problem. Parents often have little choice but to send their children off to work because increased school fees force the juvenile's parents to send them to labor. Children working in hard labor are more prone to work-related injuries and deaths. Child labor is a much deeper problem than to be summarized into black and white. There needs to be deeper research into the roots of child labor in order to find a way to stop it. In one recent case of a child labor conflict, a 15-year-old child was raped and beaten to death, and the family was denied compensation. This shows the brutality of child labor and the discrimination toward the families of the workers.
Mongolia is the third most child-labored country in all of Central Asia. Mongolia also has the worst forms of child labor. Child labor in Mongolia mainly occurs in its economy, animal herding, and mining. In total, there are about 145 million non-workers in all of Mongolia. Children work informally in petty trades, scavenging in dump sites, scavenging coal from abandoned mines, and herding animals. Figures vary as to the number of children in the labor force, but estimates are as high as 58,000. 1,695 children between the ages of 0 and 14, and 91,841 children between 15 and 19 are economically active. There is evidence that Mongolian women and teenagers are working in the sex trade in Asia and Eastern Europe. Children are employed informally as domestics and are usually received little or even no wages. The practice of adoptive servitude, in which families adopt young girls who serve as domestic servants, is socially accepted. The use of minors is common in the rug-making industry and is also existing in some extent in the textile and leather goods industry. There are also street children. There are an estimated amount of 2,000 street children that live in Mongolia. Sing with me if it's just for today. Maybe tomorrow the good Lord will take you away.
Africa, the poorest continent on the face of the earth, is believed to be the most affected place by child labor. Over 70% of the African people live and work in extremely poor conditions. There are 250 million children worldwide who are forced to toil daily. It is estimated that 32% of these deprived and underprivileged children are in Africa. These children work 12.5-hour days, from 6 a.m. to 6:30 p.m. Cocoa and diamonds are the two most well-known exports from Africa. The work that the diamond and cocoa farmers must face is arduous, and the masters of these children become very abusive and will even go to the extremes of cutting off limbs if the children disobey. Many people do not really know that children are the ones who are mining and farming the cocoa.
In India, poor children begin working at a very young age. Many work to help their families financially, while others are expected to take over the family business before they even reach age 10. As of 1986, there has been an amendment banning children under the age of 14 to work in harsh conditions. However, many working children are engaged in occupations that negatively affect their physical, mental, and emotional well-being. Very little data is provided on child trafficking and physical abuse of children in India. A recent incident involves children in the area of New Delhi being sold for 1,000 rupees, approximately 10 American dollars, for bonded labor. It's common for children to work 16-hour days for as little as 3 pennies. In 2004, there was an estimated 218 million children that were involved in child labor in India alone. 126 million of which were engaged in extremely hazardous work. 5.7 million were forced or bonded, 1.8 million in prostitution and pornography, and 1.2 million of trafficking. Girls aged 12 to 13 are the preferred choice of 90% of households. According to a UNICEF report, India has the largest number of working children, and 70% of them are under the age of 15.